money. Just to put that out there.
He about to come home, huh? If not already.
Nah, he not home yet. They still holding him. I think, bro, I think it's a weak case, in my opinion. And he was supposed to get released already, but then they held it up.
Yeah.
They're supposed to give him a bun, but I feel like they had offered him like 5 years, I think. They offered him 5 years. It's like 5 years for that much fucking money he had? Hell nah. Y'all case weak somewhere. Yeah. And they know it. Like, the case is weak somewhere. There's something in that case that is fucked up. So I was just like, hey, but free Rilo, man, a long way. So this is my beginning. Like, let's go. That was my beginning. That was 2018. Like,
taking it back. Interviews and rappers, do you feel like there's a disconnect in Houston, at least, with our artists from media? Because I'm not going to lie, I personally feel like some do show love, but a lot...
Our media as a whole for the... And I want to put this out there correctly. You know what I'm saying? Put this out there correctly.
Yeah.
Our media as a whole in Houston, for the amount of resources we have here, is trash.
For sure. Yeah.
Very trash. And it's not because of the media on. It's both. It's artists and media.
You're right.
I'm taking responsibility for it because I'm in it. So you can't say, well, it ain't my fault. Nah, you got to take responsibility for it too. If you on the team and your team lose, you can't say, oh, nigga, that shit wasn't my fault. Nah, nigga, you taking the L together. So it comes from us being slow. You know what I'm saying? We a slow city and we so widespread out. Yeah. And then the amount of competition here.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's competition in the mindset, not how many people trying to do it. It's just the fact of, like, niggas already feel like they stars.
Yeah, right. For real.
So they act like they can't reach out to you, or if they do reach out to you, you got to treat them like they a star, like, you beneath me, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Oh, you a cameraman, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, nah, fuck all that. Nigga, respect the cameraman like you respect one of these dick-sucking rappers you fuck with. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Respect the media people just like you respect them other niggas, and some niggas get that. Some niggas don't. Some niggas look at a cameraman like, man, this nigga weak. Like, I'm a hang. You know what I'm talking about?
Nah,
for sure.
Engineers, niggas dog engineers. I was like, bro, what type of shit is that? Like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So that's what I'm saying. Like, that's what niggas be on, and that's the disconnect, because they want you to do everything for free. Mm-hmm. They want you to move how you move. They want to bullshit you, and then it's like, damn, niggas don't want to do media. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, for sure.
And then niggas that do media, some of the niggas that do media, they got to understand where they at too. You feel me? Like, hey, nigga, you working. You can't try to get money off every single artist in the very beginning. You know what I'm saying? Especially if the artist is big.
Yeah.
So it's a disconnect, bro. We supposed to have so much more. And that's the reason why I've been collaborating, because I feel like a nigga can't just try to blow on his own in his city no more.
Right.
As a media platform. You know, media platforms have done it successfully and they lit. And they good, but I say in the long run, it's better to have 15 popping platforms instead of one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because once the whole city turn up, everybody gonna get money. And you can be able to get more money. That's when the advertisers and the marketing and they taking the whole look in Houston like, damn, they got six or seven or eight popping media platforms out there. So it becomes more leverage, like, hold on, man, we want y'all. Well, damn, they got them out there. This company finna say, well, damn, we gonna pay y'all $50,000 you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Well, you know, just different shit like that. Or we gonna pay y'all $50,000 every 3 months to do a commercial on y'all shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what advertising is. That's how niggas is eating off these podcasts and shit.
For sure.
But you gotta be lit as a whole city and as a personal to go get that. You know what I'm saying? But we'll see. Yeah.
Especially like the history in Houston, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's nothing new. Like, you know what I'm saying? Everybody knows, like, a crabs in a bucket.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, we had, shout out to D Solo. He was running around doing his thing on Street Flavor in the streets for sure. We respect that. We respect 979, 937, but that's something different. We talking about independent media.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Yeah, yeah.
Shout out to every media platform in Houston trying right now, bro. I see y'all. I'm trying to work with everybody I can. And it's not that I don't think I'm too good to work with nobody, but if you working and you looking like you serious, man, tap in.
For sure.
For sure. I'm with you.
And that's another thing also, don't expect I feel like that's a big misconnect between artists too. Like, they want you to go 150% and then they gonna give you about 10 and then
that too.
It's just like you also gotta want it. Like you said, you gotta work. You just can't, everybody just be wanting, like you said, free shit, and it's just like you gotta understand, like, That's why I asked a little bit about the groundwork, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah,
a lot of people don't see that shit. And it's
hell
like,
nah, nigga.
You know what I'm saying? The shaking hands and being one deep, two deep in a whole different environment. And like you said, people be blatantly disrespectful sometimes and then come back around and they need you. Man. You like, it's just...
God, thank nigga. I done went on the road and didn't make no money doing this shit.
Exactly.
Yeah. I drove to Atlanta.
Yeah.
I drove to New Orleans, Mobile, Alabama, then Atlanta. Then stopped on the way back to Houston, stopped back in Mobile, then stopped back in New Orleans and came back to Houston. You know what I'm saying? I done got on the road for this shit. I done went to Dallas, Fort Worth twice this year doing interviews, doing this shit, collaborating, creating content. And I ain't get that money back. You feel me? That was just like, hey, nigga, I'm in my lost leaders phase. You know what I'm saying? That's my lost leader phase. We spending money now to like put it to hopefully it motherfucking to come back around later on. Yeah, that's what rap was trying to do.
Yeah,
they don't realize that, but that's what this is, man. So it's just a level of respect to the grind, man. I didn't work, man. I'm one of the hardest working niggas in the game, period. Like when it come to media, ain't no nigga just like working harder than me. The hours, man. I'm talking about not just in Houston, like I'm talking about all over. Just one deep by myself. Niggas ain't working harder than me, bro. Like,
yeah.
I'm 2,000 YouTube videos, man.
Yeah.
I don't shoot music videos, you know what I'm saying? So a lot of niggas with music videos, them niggas lit as fuck, like, because they cold in what they do. But you can't compare the grind of a content creator, like, in this lane, it's to the grind of a nigga who shoot music videos. It's two different things.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't have a rap song that's popping on my channel and a popping rap artist to take his fan base and put it on my channel. So you know what I'm saying? So that's just to show niggas up. I'm like 2,000 videos in two and a half years, damn near.
Yeah.
So it's going up like that.
Hell yeah. Damn near every day I'm seeing a new.
Oh yeah. I drop content every day. I got something I'm gonna drop and when I leave this motherfucker, like every day.
Yeah, you gotta stay on their fucking necks.
Shit, like you talked a little bit about it earlier. Like, it's just a lot of shit that need to be addressed in terms of everybody working together. I know y'all talked about that in that Sauce Walker interview, too, a lot. You know what I'm saying? Like,
facts.
It's a whole, like, ecosystem type shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
fucked up right now. But
yeah. You know what I mean?
We'll see what happens.
Do you feel like it's shifting towards a more positive side, though? Or you feel like, you know, we still in the stagnant?
Talking about in Houston or the whole Texas?
Houston, more than anything.
Houston, we've been good, man. Houston is the best it's ever been when it comes to collaborating with each other. You got certain, it's like levels, and I told somebody else this. I feel like it's levels now in Houston to where are you qualified to get into a certain room yet? Mm-hmm. Meaning, does it make sense for you to be in the room with us creating as an artist?
Mm-hmm.
Like, okay, you got the certain level artists who up. They got their image already together. They got the music. They hot. Instagram followers match up. Real Instagram followers match
interactions.
Up. Interactions, fan base, as opposed to like you just a nigga who just got started a year ago and you ain't built nothing up yet. Yeah. You can't expect to be able to go and get in the studio with Sauce Walker without paying.
Yeah, for real.
Or you can't just go hang.
Putting them hours in. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Or hang around like, hey, nigga, you could just hang with me just because you want to be a rapper. Then it'll be 1,000 niggas hanging around.
Yeah.
It's like once you separate yourself from the pack, them niggas going to embrace you. You feel me? You're going to get embraced by the Houston street rappers. You know what I'm saying? Lil Jairmy, if you hard, you a good nigga, he going to embrace you. You feel me? Sauce, the whole TSF.
Yeah.
If you hard and you making noise, they not finna say, hey, if you ain't got no smut on your name and you're not a whole ass nigga and you ain't hating on nobody, if you get a buzz going, these niggas, somebody out the group of popping artists is going to embrace you.
Yeah.
So that would probably not happen as much back in the day as it will now.
Yeah.
Like it was still always a division, even when it looked like it wasn't a division, niggas still had problems with each other. That shit is over now. That North Side versus South shit been dead. And I think now niggas understand, nigga, we've got to fuck with each other. Features is lit. Now it's like niggas didn't want to do features. Now it's like, let's do a feature, nigga.
For sure.
You see artists all day, man, let's get on something.
Yeah, yeah. Let's get just on for something. Today, features all day, send them through.
Or even if it's a nigga they not finna charge, they might just see, bitch, where you at? Come to the studio, nigga. I'm trying to get you on this new tape, nigga. Come on. Like, all right, nigga, that shit would never happen back in the day. Internet play a role in it. You know what I'm saying? So. And then H-Town being the most creative city musically, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, for sure. And that's something that you said earlier, like, that shit crazy that and the city so big. You got Austin leading us in terms of like festivals and shit like that. You know what I mean? Yeah, like that yeah. shit always blow my mind. It's just like we got the resources, but at the same time, you know, like I feel like we're moving in a positive direction.
Austin a little bit more, you know, are they smaller? Commercial. They smaller and it's more white collar out mm-hmm. there. You feel me? It take like brains and tech shit to kind of think like that. Yeah. But that festival, South by Southwest Festival, been around for so long.
Yeah,
but we should have been had one too. But yeah, yeah. Austin is the music capital of the world. So it's like, shit, it makes sense to have this shit though. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
But it's just like, you know, on the flip side, like you said, you started putting the phone right here. It's about doing it, you know what I mean? So we can't just be like... It's just because, you know,
you got to get the numbers, man. Once you get the numbers, you got the say so, you got the flexibility. Your opinion is respected by your numbers. For sure. That's just what it is, you know.
Yeah, that's a fact. Yeah. So being in the media realm, especially the Houston media, you got to have your ear to the streets. So what's some new shit you've been listening to or who been catching your eye lately?
In Houston?
Houston or shit, just
okay. To be honest, I check out new shit, but every day my playlist is Money Man, and then I listen to a lot of Babyface Ray out of Detroit. Money Man, I be on that shit like all day, all night. Like that's what I jam in the car. That's what I jam when I wake up. That's what I cook food to, whatever. You know what I'm saying? But then I put other shit on too. Babyface Ray, I'm a big fan of Babyface Ray music. Mizzy. You know what I'm saying? I jam a lot of Mizzy. My playlist is a little bit different than a lot of niggas, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But I fuck with, in Houston, who I think I've just been sliding to lately out of Ace Time, who been, you know, that Peso going crazy right now. The G County, not Houston, but you know what I'm saying? G County most definitely, Texas City. Peso shit going crazy. I like him right now. Lil Jairmy. I've been on a lot of Lil Jairmy. I think Lil Jairmy ready to go to the next level.
For sure.
I want to say one of the hardest mixtapes this year, just on some street, raw, uncut street rap shit, that nigga Pee Wee, King Pee Wee, BLK. He from South Park, but he on the north too. He coming from both sides, you know what I'm saying? They in my section. We all from the same section. You know, they younger, but we all from the same section when it comes to just like, you know, outside and shit, we all in Greenspoint and shit. And I pull up to their video shoots because I believe in them niggas, especially Pee Wee. Like, the nigga, I seen him grow so fast as an artist where the flow, the everything, and they got in-house production. Yeah. They just got to keep pushing and pushing. They going to be good. But check him out, King Pee Wee, BLK, man.
King Pee Wee, like, we're gonna tap in.
Yeah, nah, that nigga hard, just on some trap, rap, what the fuck was the name of my last mixtape, man? Hold on, fuck, let me bring that up real quick. I be doing them a disservice by not shouting out the tape, man. I posted it on my page, not too well, Pee Wee BLK, man. Hold on.